I'm Arash Kamali Sarvastani. I'm one of the co-directors of the movie Chauka, Please Tell Us the Time. Chauka, Please Tell Us the Time is a movie about Australian border protection policy made with smartphone of the co-director Behrouz Bouchani. At the beginning, I was, you know, because I have small kids, because I made something, in a small documentary about kids in front of Mediterranean Sea, and I asked their idea about the sea, and I hear lots of great answer from those people. I was really interested to know what would be the idea of the kids other part of the world about the sea, especially somewhere like Nauru, a small country, really, really small country in the middle of the ocean, with a detention center. There is family and kids, and I was interested to know what's the idea of those kids about the sea. Is it like a jail for them, or, you know? I really wanted to find kids and talk with them. I couldn't. Because of different reason, but at the end, I said no. There is a crime is happening in those detention centers. It doesn't matter if I can't find kids. I should make something about those camps. So then, I found a detainee who is a Iranian Kurdish journalist who is detained in Manus detention center for the last 4 years. I found his articles in some newspapers. And I said, maybe I can work with him. He looks brave. He looks somebody that has access to the outside world. Then I found him in Facebook and said, oh, I want to make a movie about these camps. And he said, oh, I love to do that. I said, I was a student of Abbas Kiarostami. He said, oh, I love Abbas Kiarostami. So that really helped our collaboration. We liked the same way of telling the story. And then we made the movie with a smartphone. It is a smartphone. That was lots of problem. But I try to see the problems like a gift. I think if you look at this like that, you really can find something great out of these problems. Like, we had an internet speed problem. So that's why we needed to send voice messages to each other instead of Skyping. If we had a better internet quality or internet speed, we could Skype. And I believe if we would Skype, we couldn't make this movie, because when I talk to you at the moment, you are thinking about the next question. And when you're asking me the question, I'm thinking about your answer, and I always lose half of your points, and, you know, when we talk live. But these sending the messages, voice messages, give you this really big advantage to listen to somebody. We had thousands of voice messages, and thousands of voice messages in the 6 months of making this movie. And then we learned to listen to each other. Then that was one of the biggest problems we had, because one voice message could take mean like 20 minutes to arrive, to transfer. And for video messages, that would make much more time. But that was good, because we listened. We learned to listen to each other. So it was lots of problems. You know, people that are on those camps for 4 years, they have no hope. Nothing to mean. Even you want to talk with a person to be in a movie, they have no. They are scared. If they'll lose their future. There's no future, but they have a bit of hope. So it's difficult to work with these people. The other point is most of them, they have lots of problems. They eat pills because of the depression. So they are not. That's not easy to work. But so these are all problems that Behrouz could solve. I talk with Behrouz, I never talk with other actors. I talk with Behrouz and Behrouz talk with actors. So then it was other problems that, so he was scared of his safety, and if they knew that he would have, he has a smartphone, he they knew that he has a smartphone, but they didn't know if he used it as a camera to make a movie there. So he did everything really secretly, and these, how we transfer them shots and how we build this story, because we really built this story minutes by minutes. It was like 40 version of edits, and I would send 2-3 minutes of edit to him, he would see it, then he send, we would talk about that 2-3 minutes, we build it, we make some more stories, we made some more stories, it became 5 minutes, and again we talked about it, and again 10 minutes and 20 minutes, and so it was a strange project, difficult project, but I learned to see the problems like a gift, and it was a gift. The way that we made the movie, it was really important for us. You know, there is two different, or at least two different way of telling the stories about these kind of camps or crimes. You can make it like a journalist. So the journalist camera is that wants to discover everything, wants to make question and answer to questions. They don't want to make a question for you to leave you alone to find the answer yourself. They make the question, they answer the question, they don't give you any space to think. They go through all these, they want more to see blood, violence, to see more strange stories, but we did totally different thing. So we said, no, we want to see the life of these people. The camera should be stopped somewhere most of the time, just look at things. We should give the space to audience to think, to, we make question for them, but we don't necessarily answer to all the questions. We make it in a poetic way, with different layers, with different, with lots of metaphor, to play with this, with audience's mind, to tell to audience, okay, now when the movie is finished, it's not really finished, it started in your mind, and you just go through all your questions. And I think it worked. Lots of people told me, yeah, when the movie was finished, we just started thinking about lots of questions. So that is my first hope, if people think about it. I don't want to make question and give the answer. I want to make just questions. Then up to you. It depends of your knowledge. It's like a poem. When you read a poem, maybe you don't understand anything from the poem, but at least you get feeling. Yeah? If you have more artistic knowledge or word knowledge, you get more layer of that poem. If you have more politic knowledge, you get some other layers of the poem. So we try to make it like this, in a poetic way, and give the audience some space to think, to get different layers of the, because we knew that we would have different audiences. Some people knows more about these detention centers, some people have no idea. So different people get different layers, and then they can go through the questions and find the answer if they want.